The scope box is an element that you can draw in a 2D plan that has some 3D geometry associated with it, but it doesn't print. It's a way of controlling your views. Let's take a look at it in a project. From your startup screen, click on Open, browse to Chapter 5, and open Chapter 5 Scope Box. Click on Open. This project has been extended a little bit, and you can see here in the project browser that we have dependent views under HVAC for level 1, 2, and 3. I also want to do that for the roof. Now remember, when we did the duplicator as a dependent, we had to go through the process of right-click, duplicate, and duplicate as a dependent. If you've got a sizable project, that's quite an amount of time to spend. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to right-click on O1 entry level, and I'm going to apply dependent views to my roof HVAC design floor plan. Click on OK. The only thing that I have to do now is rename the views. So I'll select the first one, go to Properties, scroll down, and change its name to Roof North. Let's do that with the other two. South, and finally, Center. And I'll dock my properties palette. Okay, so back to the task in hand. What I want to do is use the scope box. I'm going to go to my overall plan for level 1. From the View tab, I'm going to click on Scope Box. Revit now asks me to click the first corner. So it is just like drawing a box. First corner. And second corner. This now gives me a scope box. It has a name, so let's call this one North. Let's also look at the 3D view. In here, you can see that we have a scope box, and it is the North one. I'm going to repeat that for the center of the building, making sure they do overlap slightly. We'll rename this one to Center, and also for South. Back to the View tab, click on Scope Box, and create my scope box for the southern region of the building, remembering to rename it South. So where does this get us? If I open up O1 entry level HVAC North, you can see that we can view the whole building. What I want to do with this view, however, is scroll down in the properties palette until I come across the extents section and I'm looking for scope box. Here it's set to none. Let's change my North plan to have the North scope box. And we've now cropped this view. I'll do the same with the South. Change the scope box to South. And finally the center. Center. So now I have my overall floor plan and my three dependent views. But the whole reason for using the scope box is that I can now come and select all the center views and apply the center scope box. Let's just close a few views and open up all the north views and we'll tile them just so that you can see what's happening. I'll come back and select the north views, come to the properties palette, and select the north scope box, and it's cropped every single view. This means their extents are identical, and when placed on the sheet, they will all look the same. So finally, Let's apply that to all the south views. Click on scope box, assign it to south, and then just open each one just to make sure that they're displaying correctly.